Groups of people lined up outside the hospital, putting more stress on medical workers as more people came in looking for help. While the pandemic is getting severe, hospitals in Taiwan experience the lack of medical resources.
为了避免人潮呢，通通挤在一块，我们看到这家医院呢进行了初步的分流，包括了如果你是快筛阳性，只需要 PCR 进行进一步确认的话呢，是一排队伍。那另外呢，如果你是轻症需要拿药的话呢，则是到另外一条队伍。那如果你是快筛阳性，但是呢有中重症的症状，则是来到急诊处这一块。尽管已经进行分流了，但是呢，可以看到每一台的队伍呢都排了非常多的人，这边有人潮甚至已经排到了外面这么多。那就算呢政府已经祭出了快筛阳性确诊还有轻症分流等相关措施，但实际来到第一线呢状况还是偏乱。
Phone lines remain busy throughout the day, causing inconvenience for citizens tested positive and is looking for an organization to provide documentation proving the applicant's COVID positive status. Facing all sorts of issues.Most citizens came to hospitals looking for immediate answers.
那卫生局很多的咨询电话也都打不通的情况之下，那他们只好跟医院求助。那间接的也把医院的这个管控部门都塞爆了。这些配套措施在规定的时候没有同时出来，就会造成一段时间的混乱。那当然，现在因为疫情的关系都没有前置作业的时间，那我们只能够以现有的这些人力跟资源尽量去应付。
In order to reduce crowds of people coming into hospitals, medical workers must serve plenty and multitask, supporting mobile rapid screening stations while answering questions from confused citizens. Besides heroes like them, another group of people serve a great purpose during tough times. Riding his motorcycle and delivering food to each household, Mr. Wong has been delivering during the peak of the pandemic. Yesterday, Mr. Wong has delivered 20 orders, with 6 orders coming from people confirmed COVID positive.For people come into close contact with COVID-positive personnel.
我们能够得到资讯就是客户的备注栏他自己写的，我们没办法确认。像我们有一些是现金单嘛，那如果没讲，那这样我们就等于说是直接跟这确诊者接触了。外送这个还是必要的，那是不是相关的配套一些机制可以出来
？Without guidance and a constant changing rule set applying to all citizens, the National Delivery Union has been talking to the government for half a month now.Yet no proper response has been made, even after a meeting with Health and Welfare Minister Chen Shizhong.
其实外送伙伴是处于无所适从的状况，因为疫情整个上升了，那所以其实相关的黑数就越来越多，可能居隔者、确诊者在家的比例就越来越高。那我们对于这种不确定的状况就越来越多。可是其实国家到现在一直到目前都没有给我们明确的指引该怎么做。指挥中心的想法是我不要特别标定出来，不要让它有社会歧视。可是其实对于我们这些还没染疫的人来讲就是风险了。
As food delivery workers face more challenges and risk during the pandemic, workers from other industries share a similar issue.
包含了其实三季历之乱造成的这个旅游业者还有我们的健身房的业者，第二个就是这个补教业者跟婴幼童的这个托育的业者，指挥中心常常都是口号治国，其实都没有做到位。如果没有办法的话，就要求地方政府跟业者要自主应变，甚至是自生自灭。
From hospitals to companies, as COVID cases piled up, if rules are not set clearly, falling behind are innocent workers affected by the lack of communication. TVBS English News.